We're back with a story that is all new at 11, and it's about the ways COVID-19 affects your health in the long term. So if you get the virus and survive, it doesn't always mean you're in the clear. And this man knows firsthand.
It hit me like a ton of bricks because I wasn't able to resume my daily normal functions.
And that's André Taylor. He contracted the virus in March. He's still fighting it in some ways. And he spoke to our John Henry about the warning he wants you to hear.
Since the pandemic began, we've heard many inspiring stories. André Taylor's is one of them. The staff at MedStar Washington Hospital Center gave the D.C. resident they dubbed the miracle a standing ovation as he left the facility in April. He had overcome the coronavirus.
That feeling was amazing.
You were in the hospital for 38 days. Tell me, what was that like for you?
I was in a coma for a long stay. I believe 21 days or so, and I was placed on a ventilator for several days.
Somehow he could still hear a television, a news reporter recalling his own battle with COVID-19.
And he specifically said, I will not die like this. And that's when I woke up. I was like, you know what? Me either.
But when Taylor got home, he noticed his heart rate continued to accelerate.
I can only walk up a flight of steps before my heart be racing, you know, like 130, 140 beats a minute.
Dr. Cyrus Hadadi, a cardiac electrophysiologist at MedStar Washington Hospital Center, said more former COVID patients are coming in with lingering heart issues.
Today, we met a patient, a lovely young lady who had no other health problems, but as a result of COVID-19, had an irregular heart rhythm.
Does it surprise you to see COVID-19 patients all these months later still have these heart issues?
But about 10 or 15% of patients will have cardiac involvement. So that's hundreds of thousands of patients who may have weakened heart or irregular heart rhythms as a result.
In early September, Hadadi performed a catheter ablation on Taylor's heart, a procedure that uses radio frequency energy to destroy the small area of tissue causing irregular heartbeats.
Really sophisticated ablation work like we do here at Washington Hospital Center has come into its own in the past 5 to 10 years.
Luckily, Taylor told us the operation worked.
I was so thankful that I did it and glad that I did it there.
A few days ago, the president tweeted, "Don't let COVID dominate your life." Well, Taylor told us it consumed his. He still has a few lingering joint issues. If you're battling heart problems after COVID, go to our website, WSA9.com. There you can see the doctor's tips on what to do next. John Henry, WSA9.